Moondoggy here, and welcome back to another reaction to my girl's MLP, which this is a animation crossover, which I adore. When I saw the picture of it, and I felt like I should share this with you guys because I love Star Wars and I love My Little Pony, and I really love the fact of the matter is that this literally is like a really, really, really beautiful, beautiful creation. And I don't know about that copyright issue on Sailor Moon yet, but I'll drop it down in the description if I find anything. So with that said, everybody, let's begin. And we're going to do all three parts. Technically, there's a fourth one coming out, but not yet. I'm jealous. I'm so jealous. If I could just steal your knowledge. God. It's midnight. Beautiful. Gotta love it. Excellent transition. I'm so jealous. Oh God, I would just die to be able to do this. The animation of it, I love it. It's breathtaking, and it hurts my heart. And it's this level of creativity that I really wish people like him can just continue and go. Like, so much ideas can just come out of this. Thank you. Not a single word is spoken, but you know what they're saying. That's how good it is. I'm that jealous. I'm envious. That my girl AJ. Oh, I love this. I love it. Just looking at this, I love it. And you can automatically tell with what images are static and what images are actually doing all the animating. I love it. I love it. Background and foreground. Oh God. If I had so much time to dedicate, I would dedicate it all to this. Once I get the technology, of course. I've never felt so in my life. The irony with all that, like, not a single word is said, which is beautiful, but you understand the story, like, explicitly. And then it gets really interesting, because when you saw, like, the combat, like, their movement is real fluid. But when it comes to combat, that's kind of a tricky. It gets real tricky with that, because it's weird to do combat without things looking so stiff and kind of... Well, obviously it's choreographed because you're the one who's making it, but like without making it seem like, you know, real chopped up and messed up. And the cleverness of this, the minute the fighting begins, it's like everything slows down for like a split second, so it does seem fluid and yet slow enough and a little stiff enough not to really drag a lot of not saying hard work into it, but a lot of like perfect example. At this point in life, we watch things at 60 frames per second. So rather than having to copy in every single moment that this is happening, I could do a trick where I can make it seem like it's going less than 60 frames per second, and yet I'm casting an illusion where it looks just fine, which that's perfectly fine, and that's really good about it. Because you see, like, when AJ was fighting, which I will wind it back just a bit, right here. right here, the movements are not fast paced. Because usually in combat, everything's real fast paced. Everything is immediate. Someone dies in less than 5 seconds for like, bam, dead. There you go. All she wrote. But here it's more choreographed where everything goes a little bit slower. You can see each blade stroke clearly and precisely. And that's really good. And it doesn't really like draw no tension that it's choppy or it's slow or it's like amateurly done. Like your animation is not realistic, because if my arm just goes limp, it goes limp. But if I cleverly mask it to make it seem like it goes limp, but actually I'm just doing it in a way where I can animate it easily without creating so much strain on myself to capture all those frames just to get that animation going to where I want. So I found that really, really good about this, and I really enjoy it. But let me stop talking. Let's get to the second one. I love it. Like that walk animation, that's very basic. And the funny thing about the walk animation, it's like right there, you just saw like three different speeds. And that's just the basics. It's amazing, like really well done. See, that's a static animation. I think that's like the hardest part, it's the eyes. As for the glow of the lightsabers themselves, I can't really tell if that's from After Effects or they're using Photoshop, Flash, and they're doing like a way where they're mixing two colors and animating them at the same time over and over. Like in an infinite loop, I mean. Not a single word said. Love it. It's crazy. It's kind of funny though. He may spike a droid, and I always thought Spike would be like Twilight's little Padawan. See, like you saw the difference in Applejack's eyes. That's something that's legit. I would have to study because capturing eyes is hard. Even like how her eyes, her pupil dilate. Me to get that. A well done and well crafted lightsaber for my girl AJ. Love it. I love the water animation. Oh. And the funny part about this, it's not even like competition, like I'm jealous that I want to be better than him. It's the idea of inspiration that I want to match him. I want to be able to do this. But then my objective is to get an art style that works enough where it's convenient to draw and it's easy to manipulate, rather than it being so highly detailed that it literally... And that's my objective, because if I can find an art style that works for me, where it's convenient, where it's easy to draw, where I can like do it in like an hour tops. Well, not like the whole drawing, I mean like a scene or an entire storyboard set up, fully detailed, in an hour. Versus then when it's time to actually animate those scenes and get them mixed together properly, color and all this and all this. And let's say I was able to animate one scene, just one scene, in a day. I would rather that be perfect rather than the idea that it takes so long, like a week or more, just to make that one scene. Not saying I don't find it being picture perfect. I would love it to be picture perfect, but then it's like, it's time consuming. And I'm not saying, you know, you don't have all the time in the world, but technically in reality you don't, because for something like this, it took him about a year for each part, and for the fact that it took you a year to make this, which I don't know how much time you dedicated for each section or whatever. I felt like, man, if I could come up to standards of an actual television show, where technically in reality they got those episodes pre-made, but like in reality, if I could like come out with an episode of something, whatever. Come out with an episode of something every week end or whatever, I feel like that's better progressed, because it's like, yeah, I'm able to actually dish this out and people can actually enjoy it. It pops just enough where it doesn't look too cringy, and yet people can get a kick out of it. And that's the objective. That's my struggle, my huge struggle, which all that in due time, because I get paid Friday, so y'all know what's happening. So, let's get back to the reaction. Sorry about that. This is a shorter one, so... Alright. Now, this is part one. Again, he's making part two now. And for how long he's gonna take to make it, we don't know. See, look at her eyes. And how they dilate out. And they come back. That, I have to learn really hard, because eyes are really, really hard for me, especially getting the retina. That's really hard for me. Now y'all, me. And then right there, creating the illusion of a glass. I don't know how to do that. I would love to know how to do that, and that's all in research. I would have to do research. Oh, I'm so looking forward to it. That. I love the outfits that he made for them. It's perfect. I love the outfits. I'm sorry. The outfits are like just as appealing as the show itself. It's that deep. Nuts, man, nuts. Thank you. should have took Fluttershy with you, but she's more or less the guardian of the temple itself, so she can't go nowhere. Oh, I love it so much. Just looking at this, it gives me goosebumps. It literally does, because I love it so much. I wish it was a thing. This should be a thing. Why isn't it a thing? God, I love it. What is that? Now watch this. This is something I want y'all to catch. Look at the clouds. And then look at that effect of coming in. That is very well done. The air, the turbulence, and how it moves the trees, all of that. Beautiful. I wonder where he get his effects from. I'm curious, like the effects to do the voicing and all that, or the after effects, you know? I'm curious to know how he got those, or what did he do to get them? I mean, a lightsaber, that's easy. But like, underwater noise, or a pulse noise, like all stuff like that. Like, where did you go? I love this song. I really hope they don't copyright me so hard. I want this. Every time. Oh, there's a pause right there. So for one, I hope we keep our footage, because I already know Star Wars, Disney, I already know they're gonna be coming after me. I already know. So we're gonna talk about that. But anyway, everybody, that's the end of. Oh, sorry about that. I had a notification. I was just trying to see what it was. So I answered you guys' comments. So, but with that said, everybody, man, that's so beautiful. I can only, I can only imagine and hope that with enough time, I can get as good. Now, it won't be 100%, I already know, but it will be close enough where you guys can really, really get a kick out of it. And it could be something that really blows up on YouTube, because I really want everybody out there to see it, because I want to show everybody these ideas I have. But enough of me rambling, enough of my wild dreams. I'm gonna drop it here, And I hope you guys enjoyed this. I enjoyed it because I love it so much. But until then, everybody, thank you all for watching, and please continue on watching. And as always, I will see y'all when the next moon rises.